Right now, Al Jazeera English is seen in 2 million American cable households.
Al Jazeera, or the island, is not in isolation anymore.
The channel's in-your-face coverage of the violent turmoil in the Middle East and Libya's emerging civil war
has grabbed it a cozy primetime slot with the U.S. And recent WikiLeaks claim Al Jazeera's now resigned director general had ties to the CIA.
What they detail is that basically the U.S. government has been monitoring Al Jazeera, the Arabic channel before the English channel started, and then after the English channel was there, they monitored Al Jazeera English as well. They went through the website, both English and Arabic, and they kept a detailed list of things that they found inaccurate, inappropriate, journalistically questionable, or simply that they didn't like. And then they would sit down with Wada and they would discuss these points.
Stepping into the open seat, a member of the royal family, fueling fears Doha's voice will get louder.
The Arabic service was duly criticized for being partisan and seeming to reflect certain elements of Qatari policy.
Hints of new angles came much earlier this year when Arab regimes started to crumble.
Tahrir Square has become a pivotal landmark in the Arab world and a symbol of the spring uprising. But the events here in Tahrir also signaled a turning point for Al Jazeera. A once vilified anti-American channel labeled extremist is now called Real Media by the State Department, as their coverage is just in line with U.S. support of a series of regime changes in North Africa and the Middle East.
The target that was set up from the beginning is to transcend Al Jazeera into an international news network.
And that they did. But the channel used to send messages from Osama to Obama and were called Al-Qaeda TV.
What Al Jazeera is doing is vicious, inaccurate, and inexcusable.
Now Al Jazeera is getting live shout-outs on local U.S. networks.
It soon might be coming to your cable box right here in our area.
This is a situation where media has become almost a combat zone in itself, and who controls media? We see it with Fox News. We see it with other channels around the world. Now we're seeing it with Al Jazeera. I think the U.S. will try to influence Al Jazeera even more.
And perhaps praise more.
Al Jazeera has been the leader in that are literally changing people's minds and attitudes.
Al Jazeera is setting the news agenda.
Or is it? Anissa Nawe, RT, Cairo.